guys for coming today. This is Los Conquistadores on a Wednesday in March with our friend Diego. We just had our two classes. The first was the beginner class, and the second one was the intermediate class. And the theme of the month, the dimension of the month, is the speed. And today we actually explore the specific concept, which is around the crosses. Very interesting crosses, not your typical salida. So in the beginner class, we actually saw that the typical salida is, you know, when you go to the side and you do the cross, it's interesting, but then you can actually lead it from simply shadow plane, where I'm going to go forwards, and then I'm going to change plane to the inside lane here, having a bit of dissociation. If I keep this dissociation and increase it a little bit, on the second step, I can ask my partner to cross, and I can cross to the back, and I can repeat this thing here until I cancel my dissociation. So, unlike the typical salida, what's interesting here is I don't dissociate and cancel, dissociate and cancel. I can keep my dissociation active, and I cross the back here. That actually makes my partner cross. In the later part of the class, what we did is basically we tried to see if we could do a false cross, but on this side, this time on the other side. So what we did is simply a cross where I'm going to establish contact with my partner's thigh, with my right thigh, and I'm going to force her to cross by really transferring my weight to the side here. And that's forcing her to cross, and I'm going to carry on. So the way to actually, the way it works is really to actually kind of transfer my axis to the side, really this way, and my thigh is really pushing her and forcing her to cross. Here, one and one and one. Then to exit, as we said, you can actually slow down, lift, that makes the lady create her feet, and off we go.
This is a little bit of a wider cross than normal, first it's on the wrong side, but it's also wider, so we're not going to end up like that, we're going to end up much wider and probably with both legs bent.
And of course, for the leader, we need to actually bend the legs so that we can reach a bit further and walk a bit of the car. We then actually saw what we can do if we combine this with a kind of a rotation to the right. So I'm going to force the cross here. As I'm here, I'm going to go back and to the side. One and two, three. Now, the difference here is that my leg position is a bit different. I'm not going to be sideways or even forward. I'm going to go back this time, but I'm having the same lead where I'm pushing the lady's leg across the cross.
Then for us, we need to make sure we transfer the weight immediately so we're ready for the pivot and then moving forward.
Now, because it's speed, the dimension we're playing with, what's interesting here is we have sudden acceleration, one hand, and then really kind of softening what we do. One hand, and then really softening what we do. And finally, to actually explore the other leg, we did a little staccato. One and two. I'm going to send my partner to the left by associating to the left. And I'm going to send my right leg here. And I'm going to produce a staccato here with my left leg. So if I do a little bit of chopping, here, one and two, three, staccato, and then I can go in here.
The staccato, depending on how high the impact is, your leg might go up or not. That depends on him. It's not safe, you don't do it on your own. If you lift your leg, you need to point it, and you also need to aim to return onto the floor as soon as possible.
Thank you. I'm